going to be secondary. Because Bob Backlund, you want a shot? You got a shot. Bring everything you got from your generation and take on the Hitman. And I guess we'll find out just who is the best.
Squares off against the WWF champion Bret Hart of the Survivor Series. There's more Survivor Series information coming at you.
Takes over the wrist. Adam Bomb, a monster of an individual, into a bit of an arm bar there.
Nice maneuver, yes indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, hammerlock applied there by Mike Bell.
And Adam Bomb looking for the escape. Nicely done.
And speaking of monsters, how would you like for your doorbell to ring on Halloween? You open it up, and there stands Adam Bomb with those weird glasses and everything.
No thanks.
That would, no, look at that.
That would certainly be a treat for many individuals. And, if there were no candy available, then I would not want to be around for Adam Bomb's tricks.
So,
Adam Bomb being set up, coming off down Mike Bell, and
Bell with a hit.
And
here we go again, a launch and a slam. Adam Bomb off the rope and drops the elbow.
Speaking of tricks, how about that trick that Bob Backlund pulled on Adam Bomb last Monday night? Monday Night Raw. You saw it, Jerry.
Yes,
Lawler.
I did.
After the match was over, Backlund ran in and hooked Adam Bomb and really cinched in that cross-faced chicken wing, a hold for which, allegedly, there is no defense.
There is absolutely no escape unless Bob Backlund feels pity, wants to have mercy, and releases his opponent.
Uh-huh. Well, I remind you, it wasn't a match with Adam Bomb. Now, Adam Bomb's match was over. Backlund comes in from behind.
Oh, what?
And applies the hold.
What do you mean from behind?
Well, I'll tell you this.
I didn't know he was there.
Well, having some success against Adam Bomb. And to the buckle now, you wonder what sort of success.
Bret the Hitman Hart, the World Wrestling Federation champion, will have against Bob Backlund at the Survivor Series. Look at this. Bomb threatening it up to the propeller, back off. Adam Bomb with a hard right hand.
You just got to wonder, McMahon. It's going to be the cross-faced chicken wing versus the sharks. Who's going to be able to get their patented hold on first?
I don't know. We're going to find out at Survivor Series, just like we're going to find out which team has the most guts, which team has the most glory indeed. And Bell, been over with a boot to the midsection, and front face lock here. That's going to happen.
Oh, down the way.
Yeah. And that should do it. Adam Bomb just chokes him a victory for himself.
However, will Adam Bomb be victorious at the Survivor Series when he teams up with the likes of Mabel, whom we mentioned earlier on, joining the Smoking Guns, Billy and Bart, and Lex Luger?
Against the $1 million team, I'm afraid that means no glory for those guns. Atlas wonders.
Oh, really?
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a Survivor Series elimination style matches. Who knows who's going to win this match between Guts and Glory and the Million Dollar Team?
Right now, let's take you to Todd Pettengill and find out more about the Survivor Series.
Welcome to your very first Survivor Series report here on WWF Superstars. I'm Todd Pettengill. Now, if you have short-term memory loss, like me, I'd advise you to grab a pencil and a piece of paper, because I have got a ton of information for you. We are now under a month away from the 8th annual WWF Survivor Series, coming to you totally live this year from the Lone Star State. I'm talking San Antonio's Freeman Coliseum, live at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, 7 Central, and exclusively on pay-per-view cable TV. As I announced last week on Monday Night Raw, the WWF Championship will be on the line this year at the Survivor Series as the Hitman Bret Hart takes on Mr. Bob Backlund. Now, obviously, the Hitman had to wait to accept Backlund's challenge till he had his match with Owen. But with that over, the Hitman will defend the title at Survivor Series against Mr. Bob Backlund. But you know what? That's still not good enough for Mr. Bob. He wants to take it a step further. Listen.
Bret Hart, it's been signed, sealed, and delivered for Survivor Series. The WWF title's on the line. And in that contract, I would like one stipulation. Let's have a submission match. The sharpshooter against the chicken wing. I have to put the chicken wing on you to win. And you're going to maybe try to put the sharpshooter on me. And in this match, we'll find out just who's going to get the towel thrown in on them in Survivor Series 1994.
Folks, the Hitman is the fightingest champion of all time in the WWF. I don't have to tell you that. Here's a guy who has never backed down from anyone, and I don't expect him to do it now. Backlund better be careful what he wishes for, because he might just get it. We'll keep you posted on the developments in this one. Right now, I want to talk about the actual Survivor Series itself. You ready? Five-men teams strive to survive in the ultimate test of strength and endurance. Now, as I announced on Monday Night Raw last week, here are the first two teams signed for the Survivor Series. Guts and Glory takes on the Million Dollar Team. Now, for Guts and Glory, it's Lex Luger, Adam Bomb, Mabel, and the Smoking Guns against Ted DiBiase's Million Dollar Team, consisting of Tatanka, King Kong Bundy, Bam Bam Bigelow, and Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies. I mean, that is absolutely awesome, right? Here's another two teams set to lock up. The Bad Guys taking on the Teamsters. For the Bad Guys, it's the Bad Guy, Razor Ramon, the 1-2-3 Kid, the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, and the Head Shrinkers. Locking up with the Teamsters, as we said, we're talking tag team champion Shawn Michaels and Diesel, Double J Jeff Jarrett, Owen Hart, and the Anvil Jim Neidhart. Can you imagine the action in the squared circle? Style and brute force? Man, however, that's still not all. Obviously, you guys have heard about The Undertaker and Yokozuna's casket match on the WWF Heart Attack Tour. You'd have to be locked in a closet somewhere not to. Well, guess what? Check this out. You will see the ultimate casket match at the WWF Survivor Series. Now, you're probably saying, I remember what happened at the Royal Rumble, and you're right. Remember those nine other WWF superstars helping Yokozuna push The Undertaker into that casket, slamming the lid? Well, take my word for it. That is not going to happen this time, and I'll tell you why. Not only will there be one official in the ring at all times, there will also be a special troubleshooting referee outside the ring at all times to make sure there's no interference. I can read your mind. You're doing it again. You're thinking, no ordinary referee can stop a WWF superstar from getting in the ring. And you know what? You're absolutely right. That's why it's not going to be an ordinary referee. Outside the ring for the casket match, legendary tough guy, and the most famous Texas Ranger of all time, the one and only Chuck Norris. And once again, Yokozuna will stare into the eyes of death.
Oh, yes. The Survivor Series. Yokozuna, a casket match. This time your friends won't be able to help you. No one will be able to help you. The World Wrestling Federation has insisted that Chuck Norris, the fifth degree black belt, be at ringside as a special troubleshooter referee. And you, Yokozuna, are going in the casket.
Yokozuna, can you look into the eye of the tiger and survive twice? You had all the cards stacked in your favor the first time. Now you must play on my rules, and my rules are final.
Under a month away from action, November the 23rd, 8 o'clock Eastern and Pacific, 7 Central, live from the Freeman Coliseum in San Antonio, Texas, and exclusively on pay-per-view cable TV. Call and place your order today. Okay. Still to come, it's the bad guy, Razor Ramon. And coming up next, Double J, Jeff Jarrett.
Ain't I great?